Hey, how you doing? It's Ty Hicks, results coach and national influence and leadership trainer. And I really want to thank you for being here with me today. If you've been paying attention to some of the video trainings that I've been sending you, hopefully you've gotten a ton of strategies. We've talked about a lot. We, first of all, did a full overview of 51 of my favorite high performance strategies that cover pretty much every area of life. Then we talked about willpower. We also talked about productivity in a much deeper way. And so what I want to talk to you about today is how to maintain motivation, how to really create an inspired life where you perpetually feel on a daily basis motivated, where it's not fleeting, where you're not taking one step forward and two steps back, but where you consistently feel compelled towards an exciting set of goals, okay? That's actually a reality that is available for you. It's a life that not many people live, but it is a life that is available. And part of it really just comes down to understanding how the brain works. And as if you've been following these strategies, if you've seen what we've been sharing, I think you're gonna see that they don't teach us this stuff in school. You know, they don't teach us, you know, how to actually become the joyous master of your psychology, how to really understand how your brain can screw you over and how to be able to access every tool that it gives you to make sure that you're creating an extraordinary life. And that's what we're going for here. So I hope to demystify motivation, and I hope to be able to help you understand how to really cultivate it so that you can be the master of creating it in your life. So when we talk about understanding motivation, here's what I really want to share with you, and this is what I want you to get excited about. I don't want to just help you learn how to have the thickest skin available, you know, to have the most willpower, to plug through the things that you don't wanna do. That's not what I think of when I think of motivation. When I say motivation, what I mean is that you feel literally magnetically drawn towards the things that you should be doing, that you feel compelled to do the things that you should be doing, that there's real alignment between your inner values, you know, what you expect of yourself, and your external conduct, how you're actually navigating your life. And that is a frictionless, seamless process where when you know you need to do something, you just do it. That's what I call personal freedom. And all of my strategies are oriented around you creating that state for yourself and for the people that you love, right? So I want to get that clear and out of the way, because when we talk about motivation, it's not just how do you build up enough energy so you can do the things you don't like to do and grit your teeth while you're doing it. I want you to be able to whistle while you work, right? I want you to feel excited about the things that you're doing. And part of it is really just about getting connected to why you're about to do those things in the first place, all right? So step number one, and by the way, none of these strategies are useful unless you actually use them and unless you actually take action with them right here, right now, all right? So if you really want to make progress, you understand that you can't just absorb ideas, you can't just hear strategies, you've got to take action. And none of this is going to do you a damn bit of good unless you do so. So get out your pen and paper, and you can pause me now if you need to, but you need to get something to write with. I highly prefer and recommend pen and actual paper as opposed to a digital format. Now, what you want to do now that you've gotten those is we're going to give you a solid couple minutes, and what you're going to do is you are going to get into an emotional state, kind of like a kid on Christmas Eve writing a letter to Santa Claus. I want you to imagine your dream life. Your life like there's no limitations, where if you tried, you couldn't fail. You know, you could have everything and anything that you possibly wanted. What the hell would your dream life look like, okay? What would your relationship look like? What would your money situation be? Where would you live? What would you be doing? What would your career and mission be? And I want you to think about everything vividly, like a daydream, and I want you to write. Don't worry about editing. Don't worry about making it seem right. There are no right answers. There's just the answers that are gonna kind of pour out of you organically. The whole point here is to just kind of brain vomit all over the page and just get everything out there that's possibly festering. And don't necessarily put an arbitrary time limit on this for yourself. You wanna write and write and write until by the end of it, you go, yeah, you know, that really is it. That's really the essence of my dream life. If it's not clear why this is important, it will be in a moment. So please trust the process. Pause right now and do this right now. Okay, I'm assuming that you executed the exercise because all of what I'm about to share with you builds on that first foundational step. So if you haven't done that, please please do it right now, okay? I'm gonna have a moment of accountability with you as your coach here and say, are you really just gonna, you know, talk about improving your life, or are you gonna do the work that's required? So part of it is doing the work that's required right here, right now. So do step one. All right, moving to step two. Now that you've gotten your dream life, okay, you've got a real vision, a real vivid imagination of what your dream life would be. Hopefully you're pretty damn excited. That should really, really excite you. And if it doesn't, you need to go back to it and you need to redo the exercise. Because you need to have on your piece of paper there the real vision of your life that excites you. Okay, that's number one. Number two is you need to go back through, and what I want you to do is I want you to circle the things that are musts for you, okay? So a lot of the things that you wrote down would probably be cool, they'd probably be nice, but I want you to circle, let's say, no more than like 10 things that would be real musts for you if you were gonna have your dream life, that would really be the foundational building blocks of your dream life, okay? Go back and do that right now. All right, now, number three. What we want to do, and this is a skill that you've got to develop, what I want to be able to share with you is the skill of active expectancy. Now, the skill of active expectancy is where you take something that you really, really want and you imagine it coming to fruition. You literally imagine what you want, but in the context of it already having had happened. That was a bit of a mouthful, okay? But what, like, for example, let's say you're trying to close a big deal at work, you know, $100,000 deal, let's say, to make the math easy. You've got a big sales meeting coming up. To practice active expectancy would be to visualize that meeting going exactly how you want it to go, imagining the sale coming to fruition and that being the successful outcome of the meeting. Now, there's a couple reasons why you need to start doing this with the things that you want and how this is going to help you stay motivated over the long haul. The reason you want to do this is there's a part of your brain called the RAS, the reticular activation system. And what happens is when you vividly imagine something that's very important to you, it gets turned on, it gets activated, and it literally starts to look out for anything that could help you achieve what you need to achieve. Napoleon Hill didn't know about the RAS, but he did know about active expectancy. What he said in his infamous book, Think and Grow Rich, which I highly recommend, by the way, is that you need to take deliberate action backed by definiteness of purpose. And when you have definiteness of purpose, it is to say that you are there to achieve a desired outcome. You have a dedicated, clear outcome that is to be achieved. And that's what the action is backing, okay? So, and you're expecting that it's going to come to fruition. Now, by doing this, there, if you've also heard of the law of attraction, this is essentially the law of attraction. It's a way for you to tap into it. But literally by visualizing the things that you want to have happen as if they've already happened, you literally access every element that you have available at your disposal. Your conscious mind, your unconscious mind, all of your emotional resources, and now all of a sudden the momentum starts to build. So you need to do this on a regular basis. Easy way to do this is just daydream. Literally dream as if you're asleep, but you're awake. You know, in the morning, do your little, you know, meditation or whatever you need to do, or when you're in the shower, just visualize your day manifesting how you want it to manifest and visualize your goals as if they've already happened, and you will help make it possible through your actions. It's a really exciting thing. Okay, I'm telling you, it works. Number four, what you really want to do if you want to maintain motivation in the long haul is you've got to not just focus on yourself and what you want. You've got to focus on somebody else. What I'm telling you is that most human beings will do far more for somebody else than they will do for themselves. And so what we've got to do is we've got to figure out what is the compelling big mission or purpose, or, you know, what is the big path of contribution that is unique to you that's going to keep you excited and taking action even when it's not convenient. So right now what I want you to do is I want you to stop and think about who is somebody, or who's, you know, what's an organization or what's a cause that you could give to. Why do you do what you do? You know, who is it all for? Do you have a romantic partner? Do you have children? You know, who is all of what you're doing for? And what is the outcome that you're trying to create for them? Get clear about that and figure out what it is that you're here to serve. Because if you get in touch with that and you honor that on a regular basis, your motivation and your inspiration and your joy for just going after your challenges in life is going to be that much higher. It's not even going to feel like work anymore. You're just going to feel excited and compelled to go out and do the things you need to do because you're serving people. That's what you want to do. Okay, so you've gotten your dream life. You figured out what your musts are, okay? I showed you how to practice active expectancy, which you kind of just did an exercise on that. And we've clarified who you're serving, okay? So now you've kind of developed kind of a roadmap in your mind of where you want your life to go. And hopefully you're pretty damn excited by this point. So now it's time to start drilling down and making plans. Now I like to use this metaphor of moving the ball down the field. Here's what I mean by this. Very often people's motivation gets sapped from them because they're focused on the top of the mountain that they want to climb as opposed to the first baby step that they need to take. Because any mountain, I don't give a shit how high it is, you can climb any mountain with enough baby steps. But the problem is you tend to look at the entire enormity of the big task and then you decide you're not going to take action at all. And that's not helpful to you or anybody, and you're certainly not going to serve people. So what we want to do is we want to make sure that you stay focused on the next play. Okay, and I use football as a metaphor here because if you're in football, right, what's the whole goal? The whole goal is to gain yardage. Some plays are going to give you 3 yards. Some plays are going to give you 30 yards. Some plays are going to cost you some yards, but you don't know that until you actually go out there and do it. So the whole point, however, is to have clarity on what your next step is. What is that next baby step that's going to move the ball just enough down the field? Because if you get enough first downs, right, it doesn't matter if you have 100 plays, you know, because you're going to get the touchdown. If you remain in possession, you're going to score, and that's what's going to end up mattering. So what is going to be the next play? So in your specific instance, let's say it's getting healthy, and you're thinking about, I want to lose 40 pounds. That might seem like a big mountain for you to climb. You're like, I don't know how I'm going to do that. All right, well, what's one simple thing you could do right now to make that happen? Okay, well, you could sign up for a gym membership. Great. So you sign up for a gym membership. Now, what's the thing you need to do? Probably go to the freaking gym. Don't just sign up for the membership, right? So in the same way, do not focus on the 100 steps you might think it's going to take. Focus on the first step. Just focus on that and annihilate it and get it done. And what this is going to do is it's going to give you a sense of victory. It's going to give you a sense of progress. All of a sudden, you'll go, holy cow, I've already taken 100 steps up this mountain. It doesn't look so far away after all. You know, I can keep doing this. That's what you want to do. So the whole point here is always know what is your next step, what is the play that's going to move the ball down the field, getting you closer to what you actually want. Focus on that. Just focus on the next play. Don't focus on the end zone just yet, okay? Use that, and I'm telling you, it's going to give you that sense of motivation. It's going to make you feel victorious, and it's going to keep you in it for the long haul. Okay, that's step number 5. Number 6 is to condition alignment. Okay, condition alignment. So this is really wrapping up everything that we've talked about. Remember what we talked about in the sense that being the joyous master of your life means that your external conduct matches your internal expectations. So you've created your dream life. You've gotten clear on what it is. You've identified what your musts are. You've found something to serve. You've created a plan. Now, what's going to be necessary for you is to condition alignment. And here's what I mean by conditioning alignment. Every time that you have an insight to take action, we call that a heart-first decision. A heart-first decision is your heart's telling you, hey, you need to go and do this thing. And if you act on that immediately, that's a heart-first decision. That is literally the act of conditioning alignment between your external conduct and your internal values, okay? Now, that's option 1. Option 2 is the option most people go with in most cases, and it's why they're stressed out as all hell and depressed. And option 2 is your heart tells you, hey, I need to go and do this thing. I need to go to the gym because I really value being healthy. But then your critical mind comes in and says, no, you don't. You need to stay home and watch Netflix. Okay, that is, if you act in accordance with that as opposed to this, you're not aligned. You're not aligning your external conduct with your internal values. Make sense? So the whole point here, if you want to become a joyous master, if you literally want to enjoy what I call personal freedom, it means you become a creature that does not hesitate. You know you need to do something, you do it. That's it. You don't think about it. You don't resolve to do it. You just do it. You make the decision and make it happen. That is what it means to live in personal freedom, and it's a possibility for you. So if you enjoyed this, please stay tuned. I've got another video coming to you soon in a couple of days on 10 simple steps to get results in any area of life. I'm literally going to show you the formula for how to improve your health, your finances, your relationships, any specific area. I'm going to show you how to create results in just 10 simple steps. You'll be able to use that for decades to improve your life in countless ways. So thank you for tuning in on 6 ways to stay motivated, to create lasting motivation. I hope this will serve you. Use it. None of this will serve you unless you actually take action with it and use it. So figure out what that next play is to move the ball down the field and take action on it right now. Thank you so much. I'll talk to you again soon. Take care.